So very good morning to all the students of class 9th D. Already we have waited a lot for all the students, and kindly join with your own name. So I would be asking one very simple question. You know, today we are going to start a story named The Snake and the Mirror. I already gave you instructions to keep beehive and pencil with you, okay? So The Snake and the Mirror. I would be asking you, because you are in adolescence age, and most of the times what we do is we stand in front of the mirror and we talk to ourselves many a times. What do you think? My question is, when you see mirror, when you see your reflection in the mirror, or when you see yourself in the mirror, what thought comes to your mind? Just raise your hand. What thought comes to your mind when you see your reflection in the mirror? What do you think of yourself? Yes, I'm very pretty, very handsome. My hair need a hair, I need to get a haircut. Whatsoever, it can be anything. Whenever you see yourself, what thought comes to your mind when you see mirror? You want to look presentable, obviously. Okay, you tell me, when do you look in the mirror? This too you can answer. Okay, Brijesh is saying, Dhairya is saying, okay, Dhairya. You need to give sensible answers only, okay? Unmute yourself, Dhairya. Yes.
Ma'am, whatever I speak, my reflection speaks same.
You talk to yourself?
Sometimes.
Sometimes you talk, start talking. You can meet yourself. Titiksha is raising hand. Yes, Titiksha.
I'm the four going outside.
Yes, you can speak.
Before going outside, we see ourselves in mirror.
Sorry, I'm not able to hear. Can you speak loudly?
And before going outside, we see ourselves into the mirror.
Okay, when you go out, you see yourself in the mirror before going out, whether you're looking good and nice and all. Bhavansh, do you look in the mirror? He's not even looking at me right now. Yes, obviously, everyone does. So Divya, you tell me, when do you see mirror? When you go out, obviously, when you're getting ready for a party and all, do you think anything when you are looking into the mirror?
Ma'am, sometimes talk to myself.
Yes, you talk to myself. Yes, okay, mute yourself. So most of the times when we see ourselves, when we are getting ready, we're wearing very nice dress, you can say nicely, we have done our hair and all. Then we say, wow, I'm looking very nice, I'm looking pretty. But it doesn't mean that all the time you keep looking in the mirror only. Fine? There are people who are self-obsessed. You know, they are obsessed about themselves, that we are so beautiful. Yes, Aryan is saying, I talk to myself, but not in front of the mirror. Okay, fine. He's sending in the chat box. So that's it. I just wanted to ask this only because I wanted you to relate to this chapter, The Snake and the Mirror, okay, which is very interesting chapter, I must say. And I would be sharing the screen with you all. But before that, beta, I would be just introducing the characters of the story to you. Clear? And still students are coming, see. Now you can see, I would be, the board is visible to you, beta. Let me introduce the characters to all of you. First of all, we have author, fine. Then we have homeopathic doctor, who's the protagonist of the story. Then we have a snake. Yes, snake is one of the characters in this story, The Snake and the Mirror. Okay, which is very important character, I must say. Mirror also, I wanted to write mirror also because mirror has, you know, a very pivotal role, but it's inanimate object. So that's why I have not written in as characters. Okay, so mirror, that object is also going to play very pivotal role. You keep in your mind, you bear this in your mind. Okay. So this is now coming back to the value points, Vidya, now. Value points. This is a story within a story, a narrative within a narrative. Now, what do you mean by story within a story? Actually, the writer of this chapter, the author, he is meeting his friends and they are talking to one another and they are telling stories to one another. So this homeopathic doctor is one of the friends of the author. So he starts telling his story. He starts narrating his own experience. So that's why I have written it's a story within a story. So the real situation is a group of friends talking to one another and author is part of that group and homeopathic doctor is also part of that group and that doctor starts narrating his experience. Okay, he starts his story. So that story starts here. Doctor has high notions about himself. I told you in the beginning, many a times when we look into the mirror, when we are looking very pretty, we are dressed up nicely, we start praising ourselves that yes, we ask others also sometimes, and sometimes we do self-praising also. Self, there is no harm in self-praising or uplifting your spirit. But yes, overdose of anything is, or excess of everything is bad. So this doctor, he has high notions. You will read in the chapter, he will say, I'm a doctor and I'm a bachelor too. On the top of that, I'm a bachelor means he's unmarried, fine, looking forward to get married. And that homeopathic doctor, and he will be saying, I'm a bachelor. And on the top of that, I'm a doctor means he is, we should not boast about our professions. We should not boast about what we have achieved. There is very thin line between being confident and being overconfident. Okay, so this doctor is overconfident that yes, I look good. He is looking into the mirror and he's all having self-praise that yes, I'm look handsome. I should grow a mustache and I would look more nice. I'm a bachelor and on the top of that, I'm a doctor. So he talks to, he indulges himself into self-talk. Fine. Then his encounter with a snake, we'll get to know. He is living in very poor surroundings. He is discussing a story or a narrative when he was, you know, becoming a doctor. When he was on the verge of becoming a doctor or a practicing doctor, you can say. And he was living in a rented room where there was no electricity, where was just a small one room rented room. Students, beta, please join Valentine. Tomorrow onwards, I won't allow. Already, it's late. Okay? So, clear? So, his encounter with the snake, sudden meeting. Encounter is a suddenly when someone comes in front of you. So, he is having all praise for himself, sitting in front of a mirror, and he was a practicing doctor at that time. He was reading a book. He was living in a rented room. And a lot of rats were there in his room. I was telling you the condition of his room. A lot of rats were there. Noises of rats could be heard easily. And you can say very stinky room it was. There was no electricity. Clear? So that kind of situation he was living in. He was having very high notions about himself. That one day I would marry a rich girl. And this is a very humorous narrative also. Humorous is very funny. You will be reading many incidents which are quite funny and you will be laughing out after reading it also. That we will be reading further. So then after meeting the snake, his reaction is recorded by the author. Okay. So this, for today only, we would be reading this much. Okay. Tomorrow onwards, I'll continue with this. Okay. All the characters, those who have joined now and still joining, let me tell you a brief introduction. Author is there, author's friend, homeopathic doctor, who's going to narrate his personal experience to him. He's the protagonist and he will be meeting a snake. And what is his reaction after seeing a snake suddenly? That is to be seen. Now I would be sharing the screen, beta, and you people also keep your books and pencils ready. Is it visible to everyone? The snake and the mirror. So we are having approximately 15 minutes with us, okay? 14, 15 minutes, and we would be able to read 1 to 2 pages. And attendance will be marked if you stay there till end. I would be unmuting, I would be asking any of you, and I'll be asking very simple questions to check whether you are there or not, okay? So, the snake and the mirror. Before you read, do you like to look at yourself in the mirror? What do you think about at such times? Have you ever seen a dog, a cat, or a bird look into a mirror? What do you think it sees? So, these are the n number of questions the writer has given, just as a practice, a pre-start to the chapter. That when we look into the mirror, sometimes we pray, sometimes we don't feel good, sometimes we start talking to ourselves, and sometimes... He's asking, have you ever seen a bird or an animal seeing into the mirror? Obviously, most of us have not seen. Now, read this humorous story about a doctor, a snake, and a mirror. Okay, humorous means a funny story. Has a snake ever coiled itself around any part of your body? See, the chapter starts with a question. Have you ever experienced a snake coiling the... What do you mean by the word coiled? A snake coils means taking rounds. You know, snake has very flexible body, and it can coil himself at any place, around a tree, around a rock, at any place. So he's saying, have you ever experienced this? A full-blooded cobra, it means a huge cobra, vigorous, you can say. All of us fell silent. Who are all of us? Author and his friends. I told you this is a story within a story. So a group of friends is sitting, and this question is being asked by homeopathic doctor. Clear? They have not used any name for him. So doctor asked the group of friends that, have you ever experienced a snake coiling around your body? All of us fell silent. The question came from the homeopath. Homeopath is that doctor. The topic came up when we were discussing snakes. We listened attentively as the doctor continued with his tale. Tale means story. So the doctor started narrating his story. Clear? It was a hot summer night. About 10 o'clock, I had my meal at the restaurant and return to my room. So this is the scenario. Very weather. What kind of weather it is? Keep listening, beta. I can ask any one of you. The weather was quite hot. It was a summer night, 10 o'clock. He had his food, and after meal, dinner, he just went back to his room. I told you this story when he was becoming a doctor. I heard a noise from above as I opened the door. The moment he opened the door, he heard noise from above. The sound was a familiar one. He already knew. One could say that the rats and I shared the room. So he and the rats were sharing room. It means there were many rats in his room. I took out my box of matches and lighted the kerosene lamp on the table. See, he was not even having electricity in his room. So you can very well imagine the condition was very bad at his part, that he was not even having a tube light or so. He was having a kerosene lamp. He lit that lamp and with a matchbox and kept it on the table. Clear? The house was not electrified. It means there was no electricity. There were no connections of electricity. He was too poor to afford electricity connection. It was a small rented room. I had just set up medical practice and my earnings were meager. Meager means very small, less amount. He had just, you know, set up his practice. He had started, he was, you can say, a young doctor. When you are an established doctor, you would be earning more. But when you are just struggling to become one, in the beginning days, initial days of your career, you have troubles. Unless and until you have your parents already who are doctors. So he was earning very small amount. He was not able to afford a good room with electricity. I had about 60 rupees in my suitcase. Beta, remember, I'm telling you, the pattern of the paper is totally changed now. Whatever we will be following for class 10th, the same will be followed for you. So be ready for objective tests also. And they are very difficult. You can get a question, how many rupees, 60, 40, 45, 50, and you get confused, fine. So you have to do thorough reading of the chapter. He was having 60 rupees in his suitcase, along with some shirts and dhotis. I also possessed one solitary black coat, which I was then wearing. Solitary means only. He was very poor that he could not afford proper clothing also. Some shirts and some dhotis and one coat which he was already wearing. I took off my black coat, white shirt and not so white vest. Not so white vest means very pale and dull, purani. And hung them up. I opened the two windows in the room. So there were how many windows? Two windows. He opened the windows when he came over there. It was an outer room with one wall facing the open yard. Fine. Outer room with one wall facing the open yard. It had a tiled roof. You can see beta, tiled roof with long supporting gables. This is a gable. This is a triangular part that rested on the beam over the wall. This is the beams. Ye do beams hai. And this gable is resting upon the beams, supported with the beams. There was no ceiling. Fine, proper ceiling chhat nahi thi. There was a regular traffic of rats to and from the beam. So there was no ceiling. That's why rats were easily entering into his room, going from his room, enjoying and doing party in his room, you can say. I made my bed and pulled it close to the wall. I lay down, but I could not sleep. I got up and went out to the veranda for a little air, but the wind god seemed to have taken time off. It means he was restless that day. He was not able to get proper windy. It was not a windy day. He was feeling very bad and feeling low. He was not able to sleep. Fine, restless he was. So I went back into the room and sat down on the chair. So he decided, let's read something. I opened the box beneath the table and took out a book, the Materia Magica. This is the name of the book because he was a practicing physician. So that's why he was into reading the books and getting the knowledge. I opened it at the table on which stood the lamp and a large mirror, and a small comb lay beside the mirror. So these are the only things, beta, which are there in his room. That shows he was not a rich doctor. He was a poverty-stricken man. So he just opened that book, kept it on the table, and on the same table, lamp was lit. A large mirror was in front of it. A small comb was there. One feels tempted to look into a mirror when it is near one. So whenever we have a mirror, you know, I have seen many kids going into the washrooms, setting their hair, and even, you know, sometimes they used to stand outside the labs and they are just seeing that whether their hair are proper or not, and they don't know whether teacher is also looking at them from inside. Fine. So when he was looking into the mirror, he had started, you know, admiring himself. I believed in making myself look handsome. I was unmarried and I was a doctor. I told you now, he was having high notions about himself. He was in high ear. I was unmarried and I was a doctor. I felt I had to make my presence felt. He's saying that if I'm unmarried and I'm doctor, I should do something to capture the attention of the people. I picked up the comb and ran through my hair. He started combing his hair. Adjusted the parting so that it looked straight and neat. Jo parting kiye hote hain baal apne. He started setting his hair and started looking and admiring himself. Again, I heard the same sound from above. On daily basis, he would hear some sound. I took a close look at my face in the mirror. I made an important decision. Underline this beta. What was the important decision? I would shave daily and grow a thin mustache to look more handsome. So, what an important decision it is. Now, before proceeding, I would like to switch on the videos, everyone. Very simple questions I would be asking. Very simple questions. And the ones who will be answering, they are present. The ones who won't be responding, whether your video is off or on, I can ask any one of you to unmute yourself. Okay, beta? So be ready for this question answer round, a brief to check whether you are paying attention to the teacher or not. Let me do this for you. So, this question goes to Prachi. Prachi, unmute yourself. Very easy question. What kind of a weather it was? Prachi, if you can speak. What kind of a weather it was?
Yes, ma'am.
What kind of a weather, beta?
Ma'am, hot weather.
Yes, it was a hot summer weather. Clear? It was a hot summer night, they have mentioned. So it means the weather was quite hot. Very good. Very easy questions. Harmeet, unmute yourself. Harmeet, what is the condition of doctor's room? Harmeet Kaur, the question for you. What is the condition of doctor's room? See, those who want answer, they are absent for me. Anybody else who would like to answer this in 2-3 sentences only? You can raise your hand. Condition of doctor's room. Very easy. Yes, Bhavansh, beta, you can speak. You have raised hand. Unmute yourself, Bhavansh.
No, myself. When the condition of the doctor room was like stinky, there were many rats in his room, and all the things were not.
There was no electricity.
No electricity.
Okay, so there were rats in his room. There was no electricity. Only a few things were there. What were the things? Now, Bhavansh, you can mute yourself. I would like to ask Lisa. Lisa, unmute yourself. What were the things present in the doctor's room?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, what
please
were
repeat the
things?
Question.
Beta, what were the things lying in doctor's room?
Ma'am, in his room, there were only two windows.
No, windows are the part of the room only. The things which he was having in his room. Was he having a mirror?
Yes, ma'am.
And what else?
A lamp.
A table. I already told you he was having a table, a lamp, a mirror, and there was a small comb. Okay, tell me, who will tell me about the clothing of the doctor? How many coats he was having? Raise your hand. Come on, I want to see those who are quick learners. Jia, can you answer this? Yes, Yes, Karanveer has raised hand. Karanveer, you can speak, beta.
Ma'am, one black code.
One black code only. Fine. So he was just having. Yes, Gia, you can speak. Some technical problem, I guess. Okay, my next question is those who bell has gone, beta. So tomorrow we would be continuing. Okay, so you just read so far and come with proper knowledge and send me your homeworks properly by after renaming your PDFs. Okay, beta, have a nice day.